adrenal gland, the microscopic study. As any other gland, adrenal gland has also got a capsule. It has got a capsule, and a capsule is sending in the trabeculae. A capsule is sending in the trabeculae. Along with this, you have the blood vessels, which are going into the substance of the gland, the trabeculae. The interior of the adrenal gland, or the substance of the adrenal gland, if you take the substance of the adrenal gland, it has got cortex and medulla. If you see this cortex, it is forming 9 parts out of 10. 9 parts are formed by the cortex, and 1 part is formed by the medulla. Okay, the cortex is further divided into 3 zones. One is zona glomerulosa. Zona glomerulosa. If you see the zona glomerulosa, it is made up of inverted U-shaped cells. These inverted U-shaped cells, they are inverted U-shaped groups of cells. You know, the arrangement of the columnar cells in such a type, where you have got a deep stain nucleus, and you also have got some vacuoles which are present. There are vacuoles which are present in these columnar cells, and you see they are all in the inverted U shape. These cells of the zona glomerulosa, they produce mineralocorticoids. You know, mineralocorticoids, what are they doing? They are helping in reabsorption of the sodium from the distal convoluted tubules of the kidney. So the mineralocorticoid is the aldosterone, right? The zona glomerulosa forms 1/5 of the cortex, and in between the cells you have got the blood vessels, and the sinusoids are present in the zona glomerulosa. Now coming to the second, that is zona fasciculata, which is the second layer of the cortex, and that is forming 3/5 of the cortex. The cells are having a name, a special name called spongiocytes. And the sinusoids, what you get here, are very long. They are vertically arranged. If you see the cells of zona fasciculata, they are almost polygonal or spherical or rounded. And in between them, they have got the vertically arranged sinusoids. Okay, so these are the sinusoids that are present in the zona fasciculata. The spongiocytes, the cells are called spongiocytes, which are having nucleus more or less in the center, and we have got vacuoles. They have got vacuoles. The vacuoles in the cells of zona fasciculata, that is the spongiocytes, are many compared to that of the columnar cells of zona glomerulosa. Also, you have got some, okay, you have got the sinusoids. Here you are able to appreciate the sinusoids, which are more vertical. The arrangement is vertical in between the spongiocytes. The zona fasciculata, which is forming 3/5 of the cortex, it is producing glucocorticoids. Now, what are the glucocorticoids? They are nothing but the cortisol and cortisone. The cortisol and cortisones, these are the glucocorticoids which are responsible for the carbohydrate and protein metabolism of the body. Then the third is zona reticularis. So here you have got zona reticularis. Now reticulum, what do you mean by reticulum? A meshwork or a network. Here if you see the cells, they are forming a network. They are forming a meshwork. You know, here we see there are so many cells which are arranged in the form of a network. And in between these cells, you have got the blood vessels. You have got the blood vessels which are present in between these cells. Okay. and the sinusoids are also present in between these cells. The cells which are present in the zona reticularis, they are having lipofuscin, one pigment called lipofuscin or lipofusin, whatever you say, lipofusin pigment plus lipid droplets. They are having lipid droplets plus lipofuscin pigment is present in the cells of zona reticularis. So here you are getting the pigment also. The vacuoles are present but very much less. So here if you see the cells which are present in the zona reticularis, they are having this pigment called lipofuscin. And what this zona reticularis forms, the 1/5 of the cortex. The 1/5 of the cortex is formed by zona reticularis and it is producing the sex hormones. What are the sex hormones? Estrogen, testosterone, that is androgens, you know, dihydroepiandrosterone is produced by this zona reticularis in a minimal quantity. And coming now to the medulla, the very special feature of the medulla, medulla develops from the neural crest derivatives. So this medulla actually is not essential for the human life. The adrenal medulla is not essential. Your cortex, whereas, is very much essential for our human life. If the adrenal cortex is damaged, then all these hormones should be given externally, then only it is compatible with the life. Otherwise, it is not possible for a person to live with damaged adrenal cortex. If you see these cells of the medulla, these cells are called, a new word for them, pheochromocytes. Pheochromocytes. These are also called as chromaffin cells. Now, why they are called chromaffin cells? Because when you stain this adrenal gland with the potassium dichromate, that is when you are subjecting to the solution of potassium dichromate this adrenal medulla, then you see the cells are having brown granules. The granules which are present, they become brownish in color. Now what is present in these brownish granules? You are having the precursors of adrenaline and noradrenaline. Now you know adrenaline is also called epinephrine and noradrenaline is also called as norepinephrine. So the precursors of this adrenaline and noradrenaline are present in those brown granules. Okay, this the adrenal medulla, when subjected to potassium bichromate, when you are subjecting to, then they become brownish in color, and that's what you are calling them as chromaffin reaction. This is called the chromaffin reaction. So let us draw those cells. Here we see the cells which are present in the adrenal medulla. The cells of the adrenal medulla, when you are trying to draw, you are having the nucleus, right? The cells are showing the nucleus and also they are showing those brown granules. Okay, the granules which are present. And please look at the board. You are having singly arranged or in groups autonomic ganglion cells in the adrenal medulla. These larger cells, these are called ganglion cells. The autonomic ganglion cells are present. They are present sometimes singly or sometimes they are present in small groups, maybe 2, maybe 4. These are the autonomic ganglion cells which are present in the adrenal medulla. And here you have got lots of sinusoids, lots of spaces, lots of blood vessels. Those are all present in the adrenal medulla. Okay, I hope you got some idea about the microscopic structure of adrenal gland. Thank you.